Bridge Club, Shuffleboard Club,
Balboa Park,
Croquet Club, and it was landscaped in large part by a young woman by the name of Kate Sessions. Over here on the right, that huge tree is called a Morton Bay Fig Tree that's native to Australia. On both sides of the roadway are jacaranda trees, which are native to Brazil. And the statue off to the right is to honor Kate Sessions. She negotiated with a lot of the mariners that came to San Diego and got them to bring back plantings for her nursery. Back to the left, those bronze figures standing there with the top hats are Alonzo Horton and Ephraim Morris. The sitting figure is to honor George W. Marston. He was the founder of the San Diego Historical Society and known as the preserver of the park. His mansion, donated by him to the city of San Diego, is at the north end of the park on this side of the park, and it's now a museum called the Marston House. Over on our left are two courses for lawn bowling. One of the many activities they have in the neighborhood section. Over on our right is Nate's Point Doggy Park. That's where the dogs bring their owners and let them run free off their leash. One of two very large dog parks here in Balboa Park. We're heading over to the Prado, or the center section of Balboa Park, by way of the Gabriel Bridge. This bridge is 1,500 feet long. It's 125 feet above Gabriel Canyon and Highway 163 down below. Up to our left is the western portion of the San Diego Zoo. San Diego Zoo inside Balboa Park covers 121 acres, and it has what they call the Sky Fari, those aerial tram buckets that go over the San Diego Zoo. Inside the zoo, they have a narrated bus tour, and you can also walk to the many exhibits inside the zoo. Over the canyon to the right, I would recommend that you not explore down in that canyon. It's not safe because it's the archery range. Man. Please take note of the very intricate facade which was created by the Piccirilli Brothers of New York. They also created the Lincoln Memorial in Washington, D.C. That building was completed for the 1915 exposition. This red tram on our left is operated by our company inside the park. That's called the Freeport Tram. And they pick up every 10 minutes at the stop of the head. Over on our right is the Alcazar Gardens. That's a replica of the Alcazar Gardens located in Seville, Spain. There are about 17 different museums and attractions here in the center portion of the park. And they also have the visitor center, which is in the corner of this building in front of us, called the House of Hospitality. They also have restrooms, and they have lemonade stands, hot dog stands. A lot of the attractions here are free. And if you're interested in going to some of the museums, you can find out about them in the Visitors Information Center. You also might want to check out the Botanical Gardens, which are ahead of us off to the right. Those are free as well. The building houses the world's largest outdoor pipe organ. It has a collection of 4,131 pipes. The top of the pipes go up to the top of the arch, about 32 feet tall. And the smallest ones are about the size of a pencil. And there's going to be a free concert tomorrow at 2 p.m. Just up ahead on our right is Piazza Bazzolone, which is a tribute to a World War II hero, Gunnery Sergeant John Bazzolone. That's a bust created in his honor. And you'll notice all the tiles etched with names of sons and daughters that have served in the armed forces of Little Italy. Gunnery Sergeant John Bozzolone had an Italian heritage, which makes the point of why he was honored here in Little Italy, but he was never actually a resident here. He was awarded the Congressional Medal of Honor, which is the nation's highest award.